We are extremely happy to be with you. And it was a long time wished for all
I too feel very happy, Mr. Gopal Krishnan, for having come from Delhi to interview me. I really feel very happy.
The first instance of question is, you know, when you look back, you know, you have a long innings in Indian music tradition. And can you say in brief, 2 or 3 minutes time, how do you feel about the accomplishment and, you know, how do you feel about your life with Carnatic music?
For more than 8 decades, I am in the field of Carnatic music as a performing artist. Music is my family heritage. My father was a great musician, a Harikatha Vidwan, a poet, a dramatist, all rolled into one. A Sanskrit scholar, Kannada scholar, Vedic scholar. And my grandfather was a very great Vedic scholar by name Venkataramana Shastri. We are all from Calicut.
Oh, Shankote.
Calicut. We came to Rudrapatnam. My forefathers. I don't know the date, of course.
Shankote, Shankote.
And Shankote is Sankete is
migration.
Oh, migration. But we as a family, my grandfather, his father, they were in Calicut. They came to Rudrapatnam from Calicut. That's why we are called Kallikote Krishna Shastri. Kallikote Rudrapatnam Venkataramana Shastri. And they were all very great Vedic scholars, Sanskrit scholars, Kannada scholars, and they were teachers also. And my mother's father, Bettarapura, Narayana Swami, Veena Narayana Swami, was a very great Vidwan. Vaidika and a vocalist also. He was a very great people who had heard him. They were saying that his music was a celestial music. Such a great artist he was. He was a close friend of Veena Sheshan of Mysore, Veena Padmanabhai of Mysore, Veena Subbanna of Mysore, Padma Bhushana Vasudevacharya of Mysore.
Contemporary
and a great friend of all these musicians, court musicians. So, music is my family heritage. So, my brothers, we are 4 brothers, they were all singing. My first brother, eldest brother, Venkatram Shastri, was a disciple of T. Chaudhariya, my list. Earlier, he was the disciple of Veena Subbanna. This Veena Subbanna was the disciple of Mysore Sadashiva Rao, Asthan Vidwan, a disciple of Valagapeta Venkatramana Bhagavata, who was the direct disciple of Tyagaraja.
So that Tyagaraja
lineage is running in my family. My one more brother, R.K. Narayana Swami, was the disciple of Musili Subramani Ayya. He was the disciple of
T. Sabeshaya.
This Sabeshaya was the disciple of Mahavaidyanatha Ayya. Mahavaidyanatha Ayya was the disciple of Malambu Chavali Venkat Subbayar. This Malambu Chavali Venkat Subbayar was a relative and disciple of Tyagaraja. My brother R.K. Narayana Swami was a disciple of Musri. That way, Tyagaraja lineage is running in my family. Music was a passion for me. I was studying, I became a graduate. Even then, I continued singing, etc. I began giving performances in my 13th year. So, for over 8 decades, I am in the field as a performing artist.
Was born in 1920.
All stalwarts, and all well-known accompanying artists have accompanied me,
yes,
and accompanying in future also. Including Palghat Muni Erwar,
yes,
Pardani Subramani Pradevar, and then C.S. Murugu Bhupati, they were all stalwarts, they have all accompanied me.
Can you elaborate the tutorial period, you know, where you were learning and all?
I had basic lessons in music from my father, Krishna Shastri. Then my brother, R.K. Venkatram Shastri, who was the eldest brother, he continued teaching me. He was, he got a job in Corporation Radio Madras in 1935, 36. He got a job on the recommendations of T. Chowdhury.
So he left Mysore.
Samuel Chowdhury of Mysore.
He left Mysore and went to Madras.
He went to Madras. After he went to Madras and became familiar with all stalwarts, I had the opportunity to meet them, to learn from them, and learn from my brother also. That way, I enriched my repertoire, my style of singing, etc. I have heard all old stalwarts like Kale Kuli Brothers, Veera, Lakshanamurti Pillai, Shambhai Vaidyanatha Bhagavatarvar, Palghat Rama Bhagavatarvar, Ramanuja Ingarvar, Musri Subramani Erwar, Pallaram Sanjeev Rao, Flute, so many big wigs. I have heard their performances.
They're in Chennai?
In Chennai and also at Mysore.
They used to come to Mysore, perform on Ramanavami, during Ramanavami season.
Can you elaborate a little more about, you know, taking one or two examples, you know, you are remembering Ariyakudi or Palladam. Earlier to Shamangudi, Bab Vishwanathaya. If you can elaborate a little more about that experience.
The characteristics.
Yeah, the concert characteristics, you know, the longer concerts for 4 to 5 hours.
Palladam Sanjeev Rao used to play Devagandhari Geetanam, Shira Sagar Shaina. Oh, wonderful. Shira Sagar Shaina used to play wonderfully well. Shambhamuli Mama. Oh.
Musri
Subramani Musri Subramani Yenta Vedu Kundu Raghava. What a beautiful performance, is it?
A little more about Musri.
Nagumomu. Morangishayi. Oh, so many geetras he made popular. Glorious performances. Kamalingas Akshaya Linga Vibho. With Chowdhury and Palghat Muni Erwar. Oh, marvelous performances.
You used to go for 5 hours.
Yes.
4.5 hours, 5 hours. Without mic.
Yeah.
No amplifier, nothing.
That can you... can you elaborate a little more about two aspects? One is the advantages of listening to longer time that concerts, and second is how the without microphone,
we could hear their natural voice.
Ah,
natural voice. Their shruti, their pitch was 2.5, 3.5.
Very high pitch, huh?
Sometime 4. Maharaj Muni Vishwanath Thairwar are singing four kattai. Such a big voice,
high pitch voice,
no microphone, nothing. The audience would sit silently and they enjoy the music. That was the days. But auditorium was very small.
Small, compact.
No relation, it's impossible to
cater
to the Rishikas, such a big auditorium. Those days are gone.
In Mysore, there's a very famous hall, built by Vidarum Krishnappa.
Shri Rama Mandira.
Vidarum Krishnappa Rama Mandira.
Very compact hall.
Very beautiful hall. Very good acoustics in hall. So that used to suit the concerts of those times.
Bala Saraswati dance.
I see.
Bala Saraswati dance. Glorious days.
And he learned most of the music just by listening. He never had any formal training. So also myself, no formal training. Constantly listening to his music, his teaching, his concerts. I got it. No formal training.
So hearing the concerts formulated my style, my repertoire, and my Sangeetic Jnanam.
No, why it is said that, you know, there was no formal training for you as a musician? It's always through listening.
What?
You can ask.
Didn't have any formal training, but you used to listen a lot of music.
Of course.
And you learned music.
Of course. I heard so many performances.
Constant listening, you know?
Constant listening. Even at Madras, even at Mysore, even at Bangalore, I used to hear.
What does it was?
And I had some training from my brother also. He used to teach me many kirtanas of Tyagaraja Dikshitar. He used to teach me as and when occasion arrived.
But he absorbed all the finer points of music.
Yes,
by listening.
The refinement
by listening to stalwarts like
He never had any training as what these students will have, no? Right from basics.
If I wanted any song, Vishwanatha would teach, Shambhuguri would teach, and even Ramanujayengar would teach. Yes, I will sing, you take down, he used to say.
He used to take
down
the notation.
I enriched my repertoire like that. And my brother also was giving tuition in rare kirtanas.
But when you teach your students, you have groomed so many good artists actually.
Sure.
Do you practice the same thing or?
Very
methodical.
Patandaram is very important. What I have learned from scholars, I teach to my students. I don't alternate.
But his teaching of his students is more scientific.
Yes.
Of course.
Why you say
that? Because nowadays listening is not that much, you know.
Yes. While teaching, if they commit any mistakes, I will correct it.
Yes.
And I will make them sing the kirtana once or twice or thrice. And they should sing it without any flaw, without any mistake. And I also give them the raga lakshana, and then swarakalpana. You know Naraval?
Yeah.
I will make them sing all these.
And the characteristics of the raga?
I don't change the patantaram of kirtana, which I have learned from stalwarts. Yes. Almost all yesteryear's musicians, I have heard their performances.
Yes.
Almost all.
And then he used to go to Madras to join his brother, you know? His elder brother R.K. Vitram Shastri used to take him to Shambhuguri's house, Parikudi's house, Vishwanatha's house, and there he used to ask them for kritis.
Okay.
I used to visit all these musicians till their end.
Yeah. So you were not conforming to one style actually. You were learning process was that you used to accept everything.
I have my own style.
Yeah.
But Bharo,
that style is the outcome of my listening to these stars.
Now, how do you relate your music vis-a-vis Mysore Bani and Tanjavur Bani, the so-called?
There is no difference. There is no difference between Mysore Bani and Tanjavur Bani.
But in olden days,
there was a difference in little. But when these solvers, musicians were coming to Mysore and Bangalore and giving performances, this Mysore Bani went out
completely.
And Tanjavur Bani
remained.
Tanjavur Bani is Gamaka Shuddham.
Gamaka
Shuddham. Gamaka oriented. And the Tanjavur Vani is full of Sangatis, that is embellishing the Sahityam by introducing so many Sangatis and also improvising the Ragaswarupa by introducing Sangatis. That was Tanjavur Vani. Gamaka Shuddham, Sangatis, and then Kala Pramanam. For every song,
tempo.
There would be some tempo. Middle Kala, Madhyam Kalam, that is slow tempo.
Faster, middle tempo,
yeah. And speed.
Yeah.
Three tempos. They used to sing so many gaitaras in Vilumbakaram, Madhyamakaram, and Dhritakaram. All these technical points were very important, and I imbibed all those points also.
When you look at the Hindustani music traditions, taking Mysore Bani and Tanjavur Bani, you know, which has more resemblance of the Hindustani?
No, there is no resemblance. Nothing, no resemblance at all. Our system of music is very, very
incomparable. It is incomparable.
Very great system.
Very great system.
Can you elaborate a little more?
The number of ragas.
Carnatic music is highly systematic. And then Sahitya oriented music.
Kala oriented.
Bhakti content. Rakti, Bhakti, Bhava. These three ingredients are very important in Carnatic music. In Hindustani music, usually Hindustani music is Darbari music.
More entertaining.
Darbari music.
Entertaining.
More to please
the audience,
the Nawab or the Raja. But Carnatic music is Bhakti oriented.
Raja is him.
Devotion to God.
It's a prayer to the Lord of the universe. Hindustani music is not like that.
And even Tala system is very intricate.
Excluding bhajans.
Yeah.
Excluding bhajans, Hindustani music is not bhakti oriented. Bhajans are bhakti oriented. Kabir, Meera, Narasimha Mehta, Sourdas, those their compositions are bhakti oriented compositions. But our treatment of a song, our treatment of a raga is quite different from Hindustani's treatment or singing a cheese. Very, very different. World of difference.
And we have intricate tala systems.
Oh, so.
Which you don't
108 talas. 108 talas. 35 important talas. If you multiply it, it becomes 75.
We don't find
that
in Hindustan music.
No. We don't have so much of Tala intricacies in Hindustan.
We don't find Tala variety, we don't find Raga variety in Hindustan.
They have Raga variety, but not so.
Ours is thousands.
Yeah. Oh, you.
Our Raga system has got thousands of
such. 72 parent Ragas give birth to so many children.
You don't find in Hindustan music, you don't find that. You don't find those.
We don't have so much of ragas in Hindustani music. Particularly, their way of singing is quite different from Carnatic style.
The way they give gaukas is totally different.
You started giving public concerts at the age of 30.
From my 13th year. Yes.
And that means, you know, almost 70 years you are...
8 decades.
And you have seen a sea change in the patterns of the concert, the performance. Suppose if you take one composition, you do the duration for a ragalapana, the speed, the microphone came into the scene. But you are some sort of a bridge linking many generations.
Old and new.
And how do you rate the changes that occurred into the content of the music, as a performance, as a theory, as its philosophy, lot of changes have happened. And how do you see all these changes as you have witnessed all these changes?
Of course. Now, performers are introducing some changes in their performance, in their concert pattern. I think those changes are not desirable. Because they mar the beauty of the traditional Kashmiri pattern, which senior musicians, stalwarts, have given. That pattern is really very, very grand, very absorbing, it's very grand. Why should we change it unnecessarily? If I want to have some change, that should be complementary to the traditional pattern of music. Then I can welcome the change. If it is not like that, why should I have that change? Now some musicians are giving some changes. I should not mention that.
They introduce changes in the name of innovation.
You can say they are very innovative, they are very creative.
They think they are very intelligent.
Usually, if I sing a raga, I sing a song in that raga, and then I give chance to Taniyavartan. Now, what musicians do? They sing one raga, then again second raga, then again third raga.
And a different kriti.
No, they don't sing any kriti. They give chance to Taniyavartan. That is only raga rapana and then Taniyavartan. What kind of change is this?
And
what is the beauty of this change? What is the
purpose
of this change? Why should I introduce that change? Does it
enrich any?
Would it be complementary to the old tradition?
No.
Like that. No answer. Oh, it is my wish. I am innovative. Why should I sing a kriti? I sing all the ragas and give Tanya a chance for Tanya what from this.
They call it as raga pravaham.
Raga pravaham. That's all. No kirtana, no sahitya.
No sahitya, no lyrics.
I don't think these
changes. Because such sahitya and sangeet are complementary.
Desirable.
Sahitya and sangeet are complementary to each other. The raga bhava is brought out in sahitya. Sahitya helps to bring out the raga bhava.
And then,
complementary to each other.
Why should not we begin your concert from Mangalam?
Oh, yeah. I know what you are mentioning.
Is it desirable?
No.
Yeah.
Right. They call it innovation.
Now, another point, you know, it is not a question. No, whenever we listen to you, your live performances and all, always we have a feeling that, you know, you are a thinking musician while performing. You know, this is some sort of within your musician, there is a music philosopher who is continue to think while performing. And that too with much precision.
Oh.
And that is there even in your body language while singing. You have a meditative posture while singing.
Yes.
And this goes very well with your music also.
Mm-hmm.
The stream of your music is very there, very precise.
Yes.
It has, you know, I will say that, you know, it has no unwanted ornamentation.
Of course.
This is an observation. And how do you reflect about that?
This observation is really very good.
Classical purity.
Yes. We should give importance to bhava. While I sing a kirtana or a song, I should get into the shoes of the composer and also know the meaning of the kriti And then if you try to sing, you will be in a meditating mood. Then bhava comes out naturally. If not, it will be mechanical rendering of a song. So, you meditate on the sahitya content of the song, and also vagyayakaras, that is composer's mind, composer's mind, and then try to sing that. That will be bhava redan, and it will really please the audience.
Yeah.
That should be the way how to we present a song.
Another question I have. You have seen Muruga Bhupati, you have seen Palani Subramanya Pillai, you have heard Madhura Somu singing.
Oh.
Then my thing is, there is a history in the sociological aspect of Carnatic music. Many artists who the vocal music, I'm not saying about the Nagaswaram traditions,
singers.
The singers, there have been a history of humiliations when it comes to the non-Brahmin musicians. It is said. How, you know, because this type of reading history is a pattern now in the sociological field. Now we don't have any people other than you who lived all these years and who still have that
memory.
Then how do you feel, you know, whether people like Somu or even the Mridangam accompanies who happen to be from earlier to Palakkad Maniyayyar and all, you know, who are not there. How that outside the stage, how these people were treated? I'm asking a question which has nothing to do with music.
Of course, they were treated very well. These musicians were treated very well. With all, what shall I say?
Respect.
With all respect. They were, they used to be treated like that. Of course. And there was no caste difference.
Discrimination, nothing.
No discrimination. They were all treated very well.
Palakkad used to play with
Kanjara Vidvan. Palanis Kanjara, Palakkad Mridanga. Dakshinamurthi Pillai Kanjara, Palakkad Maniyar Mridanga. Oh.
Dakshinamurthi Pillai used to sit in the front.
Palakkad Maniyar was treating Dakshinamurthi Pillai as his guru. Such was the respect.
Can you elaborate a little more the Dakshinamurthi Pillai Palakkad Maniyar relation?
Combination
and their equations and all?
Very cordial
relationship
between the singer and the Mridangam Vidwan. You see, Dakshinamurthi Pillai was older than Palakkad Maniyar. Dakshinamurthi Pillai would sit in the front. And then
at the back, at the side. He used to sit in the side.
Palakkad Maniyar used to
sit at the side.
In the side. Dakshinamurthi Pillai.
In the front, in the front.
And he Maniyar used to adore Dakshinamurthi Pillai as his guru. Like that, Palani Subramanyam and the Maniyar, they were very cordial,
very friendly
artists.
Another point, when it comes to Tanjavur and later the Chennai music traditions, the Nagaswaram was there. And even people like Shemangudi and always says that, you know, how they imbibe the Nagaswaram traditions.
Nagaswaram influence on Carnatic music is very, very great. For Raja Dapadam, Nagaswaram recital is the clue. How to elaborate a raga? Learn it from the Nagaswaram performance. That was...
Okay, what is the strength of Nagaswaram as far as Dragalabana is concerned?
Oh, Lord. Their, what should I say? Limitless. Oh, yo, wonderful creativity.
It used to faculty. Go for hours.
Wonderful creativity. Limitless Agavanu. You see, in Mysore, after Ramanavami Utsavam, they used to conduct Harmantotsavam.
Oh, I see.
During Harmantotsavam,
in the palace,
these stalwarts, Nageswar Vidwans, used to come to Mysore and play. They used to follow the procession of Anjaneya Hanumanta. Once, Radharatham Pillai, Nageswaram Chakravarti, he had been invited to play Nageswaram during the procession. We were all very curious to hear his Nageswaram. The procession started at 10 o'clock in the night. After one or two songs, he took Toli Ragam. The procession came to Ram Mandiram at early morning 4:30. Even then, the Toli Ragam was there. It was not exhausted at all.
It was fresh.
He finished then, played one song, and the procession ended. See his creativity.
Elaborate.
What a marvelous elaboration.
And no repetition
wonderful
of samadhi.
Capacity. Wonderful. No wonderful samadhi dharma. This is the clue for Carnatic vocal musicians to elaborate a raga.
Oh.
The influence of Nageswara is very, very important.
And you wanted to say that there have been frequent visits of Nageswaram artists even to Mysore?
Of course. Viru Swami Pillai, Tiruvendar Sundarmudi Pillai, Angappa Pillai, Radharatham Pillai, Meenakshi Sundaram Tamil, Nachiyar Kovil Raghavayya, Raghava Pillai Tamil. Malay Gulam, on hearing Nachiyar Kovil Raghava Pillai Tamil, wonderful artist. Wonderful. He said in the academy, Madras Music Academy. A great player. Meenakshi Sundaram, great player. Meenakshi Sundaram, Rajaratnam. Meenakshi Sundaram, Angappa Pillai. Glorious, yes, I say.
And you had the opportunity of listening to all these
songs. Of course. Our family, my brothers, we are all going, we are all used to go behind the procession till 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning. And used to
go. Okay, now when it comes to Veena, okay, now from Nageswaram, we know how the Raga Ravana path and all the vocalists.
That pattern came from Raga.
Okay, now how Veena influenced the vocal? Do you feel?
Veena can influence the vocal through Gamakas only.
I see.
For Gamakas, Veena is the authority. Veena is the authority. All these 15 type of gamakas can be produced on the Veena, not in the vocal.
But it is other way around. Veena has been influenced by vocalists.
Of course, that's better.
That is a two different styles.
For Carnatic music,
Veena is the authority. The two for gamakas. And Tanam. That is singing the ragam in Madhyam Kalam. Veena is the only instrument which can guide us for Tana singing. It's very important.
And you, in the beginning, you said your exposure, your family lineage exposure to Harikatha.
Yes.
Harikatha artists were there.
Chagraj Shishikram.
Yes. And can you say a little your remembrance of great Harikatha performances of the past?
Oh. Annasami Bhagavatar, Saraswati Bhai, Karikambujam, Yerivili Kumari, in Karnataka, Venugopal Das, Krishna Bhagavatar,
Karikam,
Krishna Bhagavatar. Pradu Sitaram Shastri. These artists are from Karnataka. That is Krishna Bhagavatar, Kodunur Sitaram Shastri, Erivini Kumari, Ved Gopala.
Das.
But what used to be the content of this thing? That will be the only Harika, Vishnu Vaishnavite or
Both.
Episode 60 from Ramayana.
That's also a difference.
Okay. Any,
I mean, everything is okay. These Madhva Harikatha Vidvans were giving only Harikatha Kalakshepam on Vishnu, Narayana, Krishna, Darsha.
Okay.
No Ishvara, no Lord.
Okay.
And can you recollect listening to Hindustani masters? Because Mysore was the place where all these.
Fayaz Khan.
Roshanara
Begum.
Bade Gulam.
Devi Puruskar. Pandit Krishna Rao.
Shana Pandit.
Oh, glorious. Pandit Krishna Rao.
You say Pandit Krishna Rao Shankar Pandit?
Yes.
Gwalior?
Yes. Gwalior.
Shamanir. So many sides.
Omkarnath Thakur.
The two in the Madras Music Academy.
Okay. Would you listen to Abdul Karim Khan?
Abdul.
Must be
for Gangubai. Of course, Bhim Sen Joshi.
Kesarbhai.
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 Yes. Kesarbhai Kesar. Yes. I heard her performance on the radio.
Okay.
She had come to Dharwar for a public performance. I could not go.
Oh. Well, those days they used to come to Mysore also, no?
Yes.
Mysore was the seat of
The royal family of Mysore would invite all these stalwarts, I think.
They were famous patron.
Govardhan?
Yeah.
Govardhan is a great musician.
Yes.
Maikatullah Khan Sitar, great musician. Abdul Karim Khan.
And can you say the patronage of the royal family, how they help the music?
It's wonderful.
Contribution is very good.
Contribution is very rich.
Very great.
They encourage music, dance, drama, even Western music.
We have seen Balasarsuri's dance, with the Jayama's music.
Can you recollect that? Balasarasudhi and Jayama.
Jayama singing, Balasarasudhi dancing.
She used to sing a jawli. Balasarasudhi would
dance.
Give abhinaya.
Without costumes.
With costumes.
Okay.
With costumes.
Jayama.
Krishna ni vegane varo. She used to
give abhinayam
for that.
And in creating that atmosphere.
Of course, Krishna ni vegane maro. Krishna ni vegane mukhavane to. I can't. Wonderful.
Jayama used to sing.
Jayama would sing very well. Bhava-laden music. Params and Jamalis, Tillanas.
Brinda Mukta also.
Brinda Mukta, granddaughters of
Jayama is the daughter of Balasarasudhi.
He used to sing very well. Traditional music. Bhava-laden music. Gamakashuddha. Marubari korvale dura unjavli. Marubari korvale dura aurana samibari korvale dura. Abhinaya.
Wonderful music, wonderful abhinaya. Very good combination.
the audience would be
swaying their heads,
nodding their head like this.
I have two more questions. One is about the secrecy of your longevity, the healthy life, and your vocal cord.
My way of life, habits, food,
practice,
maintenance of the voice.
No, maintenance of voice, can you explain?
No ice creams, no drinks, no tobacco, no oily stuffs, sattvik ahar. That will keep your body very well.
And talking less.
Practice daily.
Talking less.
Talk, of course.
Less talking.
There are so many details. So many details. Have good rest. And don't perform every day.
Okay.
Don't perform every day. You will lose your life.
Yes.
And your health will be upset.
Yes.
Don't perform every day. If you have performance today, give at least 3 days rest for your voice. If not, you will lose the madhuryam of your voice. Your voice becomes rough. And so many rules and regulations to maintain good health,
positive thinking,
and mental health.
Mental health.
Always positive thinking. No negative thinking. Always positive thinking. That keeps you very well. Discipline, of course. Discipline life.
The second thing about your, you said about your gurus, and we know that you are one of the greatest teachers Carnatic music ever produced. As a teacher, your expectations from a student, and about your Shishya Parampara, and if you can explain about it.
What is your way of teaching? It is very scientific,
no? Of course, it's very difficult to tell it in English, I say.
No, you can say in your language.
Sangeet on the hill called Vekadre, Madhuru is Shruti Shuddha, Uccharne Shuddha,
pronounce,
Uccharne Shuddha, Shruti Shuddha, Lai Shuddha, and then Bhava Shuddha.
All these aspects.
These four
aspects
are very, very important. I give importance to these aspects while I teach. First of all, Sahitya Vanda, Vidyatrikalik Madhul, Shuddha Sahitya. Lyrics, Shuddha lyrics in our head. Adana Barkobeku. Avele, Vandu Sankti Yagi, Swaraman Heli, Asankti Ili, Swaraman Heli, Sahityamannu Heli, distribution of words, Sangati, distribution of words. Adunala Heli, Adun Harse, Harse, Avele, Vandundang, Sankirana, Mr. Skun Hogar. Palavi Bhagavatra, you would help Kuror. Next day, Anupadavi.
Next day,
the other day, Charana. And then they should sing the whole Kirtana once, and if they commit any mistake, they have. This is the way of teaching, quite right.
And the students should be punctual.
Oh, of course, they should be very punctual. They should come to time, have their lessons, and get out. No unnecessary talks. No unnecessary gossiping, either, nothing. That's why I told you positive thinking.
Yes.
Very important. Physical health, mental health are very important. Very happy. Thank you very much.